Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new chapter of your supplementary book. It is your fourth chapter, and the name of the chapter is The Old Clock Shop. So this is a short story about the interaction of people and how festive season brings well-being to them. In this story, there is an old person whose name is Ray, and he repairs watches in his shop in Salt Lake City, USA, and he also purchases watches from people who need money. Now I'm going to read the chapter. Christmas Eve had arrived as last minute shoppers were going home. A thick white sheet of snow lay over Salt Lake City, USA. Yet the lights were still burning in the old clock shop as Ray, its old deaf owner, worked on a clock he had sold that day. So the story begins with the festive environment of Christmas, and people were purchasing goods and accessories for their Christmas. It was a late night, and Ray decided to close the shop. He was ready to close his shop. He was working on a clock that he had sold that day. So, having finished his work, Ray stood up and was on his way to back from where a cold rush of air from the front door hit the back of his neck. So, after completing his work, Ray was ready to go to his home, and as he was ready to go to home, a cold rush of air from the front door hit the back of his neck, and he turned to meet a last minute shopper, but his old wise eyes told him that this was not a shopper. He saw two men, one in his 20s, the other closer to 50. The younger man remained at the door, and the older man approached the counter with no sign of friendliness in his eyes. Ray was able to hide his growing fear as he slowly pushed a notepad and a pencil across the counter. So, as he was ready to go home, he saw that two customers came inside his shop, and there were two men. One was of 20 and other was of 50, and the man who was of 20 remained at the door, and the older man approached to the counter with no sign of friendliness, with no smile in his face or eyes, and Ray was able to understand that they were not customers. So Ray somehow managed to hide his fear as he slowly pushed a notepad and a pencil across the counter. So he smiled at the unfriendly face, then pointed to his ears and shook his head from side to side. A quick look of surprise changed the man's face as he studied the notepad, then turned and said something to his friends. So, wait for a second. He smiled at the unfriendly face and then pointed to his ears and shook his head from side to side. So, Ray smiled and he pointed to his ears and shook his head from side to side. He was saying that he was not able to hear. He was trying to give a sign that he was deaf. So Ray offered him a notepad and a pencil, and by making signs, Ray told him that he was deaf and dumb. The surprised old man turned back and said something to his young companion. Now Ray used the chance to look closely at the man, paying attention to the shape of a gun and a restless hand in the man's right coat pocket. Anger boiled within him, but it was kept down by an inner voice that said, "Be still." He wrote on the notepad, "May I help you?" For the first time, the older man looked directly at Ray and smiled, a cruel, mocking smile. They both understand why he was there, why his friend remained at the door. They looked like men who were down on their luck and were now ready to try something they would later be sorry about. So, in the meantime, Ray had seen that the old man was carrying a gun in his pocket, and obviously they came to rob Ray of his money. Ray became angry, but controlling his anger, Ray wrote on the notepad that how may he help them. The old man now looked into Ray's eyes and smiled. The smile was cruel, mocking smile. Ray wrote again, "Have you come to pick sorry?" So the smile that the old man gave was cruel, mocking smile. And Ray believed that the man who came to his shop were down on their luck and were ready to rob him, but they would be later sorry about. The clock ticked on. Ray calmly wrote another message, "Have you come to pick up a clock or watch?" As the time passed, Ray politely and calmly wrote another message, "Have you come to purchase a clock or watch?" Then he pointed to the lone board filled with hanging clocks and pocket watches. He was not a pawnbroker, but at the same time couldn't say no to the needy people who placed their old watches or clocks before him for anything they could get. He loaned more than he should. They would be there when the owner wanted them back, at the same price he had paid with no interest. So Ray, after some time, Ray wrote again, "Have you come to purchase a clock or a watch?" With gestures, Ray told him that, and the old man pointed at the signboard of loan. But Ray did not offer loan because he was not a pawnbroker. But at the same time, he couldn't say no to the needy people who placed their watches and clocks before him for anything they could get. In return, they wanted money. So Ray was a kind person. He helped them, those who were in need. So they would be there when the owners wanted them back, at the same price he had paid with no interest. So Ray was a kind person, and anyone who needs his help in return, Ray would give him loan. Then the older man seemed to feel little easier, took out his hand from his pocket and quickly looked at the watch on his wrist. "How much will you give me for this?" the man wrote. So the old man was now calm and took out his hand from his pocket and quickly looked, and he was wearing a watch, and looked at the watch on his wrist, and he asked Ray that how much would he give him for this. The man wrote on the notepad. Ray noticed a little shame in the gray eyes looking at him. So the watch was nothing special and yet had a great powers. So Ray was able to identify that the old man was now ashamed of his activity, and the watch the old man was showing was nothing special, but Ray believed that the watch had great powers. It was something to exchange a way out of a bad situation. So Ray believed that the watch was so expensive at that time to get out of that worse situation. Knowing that great need had brought the man to his shop in the first place, Ray asked, "How much do you need for it?" Or the reply came back on the notepad, "Whatever it's worth." So when then managing the situation, or Ray believed that it was the good deal. It was a good deal for him to get out of the bad worse situation. So Ray asked him that how much he need for it, and the old man replied that whatever its value is. So Ray reached into his cash box, pulled out a $50 note, and passed it into the man's hand. As they shook hands, Ray looked into the man's eyes. They seemed to thank you. They both knew the watch wasn't worth that much. Before turning to leave, the man wrote, "I will be back to pick it up as soon as I can. Merry Christmas." So Ray offered him $50 and sorry, Ray offered $50 for the watch and took his watch. And the old man took the note and wrote he will come back. And the old man, after taking the $50, wrote on the notepad that he will come back to pick it up, and said Merry and wished Merry Christmas. The little story ended on the half hour with the clocks striking altogether. The timepieces, which had been looking on silently all the while, rang out the time with such feeling that even Ray thought he could hear them. Their sweet musical message was filled with hope. The timeless message of peace on earth, goodwill towards all, was felt by the three men who stood in the old clock shop. So Ray and the old man both feel that, and both knew that the watch didn't cost the worth. The watch was not value of $50, but it was the best deal at that time. So suddenly, when Ray offered $50 and the old man wished him Merry Christmas and wrote that he will come back and take the watch, suddenly the clock started ringing and it was over half an hour. So these and there was a hope all around, and the timeless message was peace on earth, goodwill towards all. So was felt by the three men who stood in the old clock shop. So all three understood goodwill and hope, the value of goodwill and hope at that particular time. So this was the explanation of the chapter. I hope it is clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can comment us on Google Classroom. Thank you and have a good day.